Presumably, you have a student portfolio and it's going to be stored in your Google Drive. The best case is to put it into its own folder and call it something like EH Student Portfolio. This folder can be shared. Going to click the down arrow and show you how to get a shareable link. This link can be given to students. The important thing is that the access for the link says viewer. Okay, so you're going to copy the link, and this is the link that you'll give to students. What this accomplishes is students will be able to click the link and access this folder. They will also be able to click the portfolio. This portfolio, once they click it, will not be editable, but they can make their own copy. I'll show you in the next step. I am a student, and I am going to copy the link that you gave me from that folder that was view only, and I'm going to put it into my browser URL. And it's going to bring me into the Google Drive, into a place shared with me. And notice that I am in the EH Student Portfolio Template folder. If I click once on the portfolio template, I can go over to the three dots and click Make a Copy. Then it's going to make a copy for me that is my own, and it's going to be in my student drive. Notice something. If I'm a student and I don't follow directions, and I click and I open the portfolio template, what happens is I am looking at the portfolio template and all the wonderful pages that have been added. However, I can't do anything to it. I can't edit it. I can't even make a copy from this screen. So even if they don't listen to your directions, they're not going to get anywhere unless they listen by clicking once and then going to the three dots and clicking Make a Copy. Once they make that copy, you'll see a little black box come up saying created a copy of Portfolio EH. It's in your drive. They can click Show File Location and it will take them to where it is. And here it is right here. You created this just now. It's called Copy of Portfolio. And this is going to live in their Google Drive. And now the next step is for them to go up here and give their portfolio a name, presumably their name. Put their name here. Once they've given it a name, so let's say I just make it student name, and they go over to this button that says publish. This is going to generate the URL for them or the link at which their portfolio will live. When they click publish, they get to give it a web address. They can use their name and click publish, and the official URL of their site should be, and let's look at it, sites.google.com, and then their name, student name. They can copy that link and give it to you. What I might also suggest is that you have the students share this portfolio with you or their homeroom teacher. It will be restricted. Basically, it cannot be looked up unless you want them to change it to Bethlehem Area School District. But they should add their homeroom teacher as a collaborator. That way, when they do not publish something, and it's only in draft form, you can still see it in draft form.